Oh, yeah.
Figure that out later for him. All right, let's go ahead and get right into this, man. We are here on Battlefield. Now, Battlefield is one of those stages I kind of like for Rob. I mean, I like if he's on my team. I don't like fighting him, but, man, he gets – I actually had the opportunity to fight Mr. Eric because I stayed with Lordstrom for Smash and Splash, and Junebug stayed for a while, and Mr. Eric stayed tonight, and I played him. And, man, I will say, dude, if I get hit with another up air on Battlefield, I'm going to have a problem. He can land those so efficiently and so smoothly, man. It's so difficult to deal with. Wow, good air dodge.
Yeah, nice air dodge there because that was going to be a dead Palutena at 60%.
That it was. And whiffs the KO punch somehow. And, wow, Lincoln actually whiffing the up air. Now, that could have been a dead Mac.
No.
Mac is actually top 10 lightest characters in the game. I mean, he looks heavy. He's far from it.
And we actually kind of overlooked Kwaaaaz taking his teammate's stock there with an up tilt.
Mm-hmm.
Very sad to see. Whipping a KO punch and then taking out your own teammate.
Absolutely, man. When you're teaming with somebody like Kwaaaaz, the name of the game is how is Kwaaaaz feeling and how long can Mac live? If Kwaaaaz is feeling good and Mac is living forever, then we're in good shape. And I understand that the name of the game is who can live the longest, but Mac is a different story. If you're teaming with him, you have to make sure that he lives as long as possible, or is this going to be a rough ride for you through the rest of the set?
We saw some very magnificent gameplay last Hypertension from Nev keeping Kwaaaaz alive multiple times. Mm-hmm. He hopped off the stage under Kwaaaaz and would hit him with an up air to rise him back towards the stage.
Absolutely. I definitely agree, man. And we've been seeing that actually a little bit here today as well. He saved Kwaaaaz a couple times with his up air earlier today in bracket and a couple times off stream too when I was actually watching. So he's doing a very good job in knowing where Kwaaaaz is weak and knowing where he is good at. And on a stage like this, stay away from Mac as much as possible. Let him do his 2 1v1s. And then the minute he gets off stage, get out there and help him.
Now, the one thing I really question about Kwaaaaz sometimes is doubles is his decision-making on when to attack and when not to attack. Just a few moments ago, we saw Quad. Oh, no! We just saw Palutena lose a stock from a KO punch. Right now, I'm pretty sure Skilliger is not happy at all.
Absolutely not. He's doing his ear thing. He is not happy.
But what I was saying, Quad A got a grab on Link, and in the grab motion, Kwaaaaz decided to come over and do an up smash, which was a horrible decision because Link was not in kill percent. So what he did was he hit Link and also hit Quad A. So they both took damage instead of just Link taking damage if he would have let Wesley do one of his Rob follow-ups.
Definitely, man. Now, one thing I do want to shine light on is how well Brett is keeping this match into his horizons. Yes, they are down a stock. Yes, they are down in percents. But with the forward smash on Mac and a dash attack on Quad A, this things are looking a bit more in their favor.
He's going to live.
Tall ceilings, but as he lands, eats a sour forward smash. Unfortunately, sends him into the abyss, and Palutena is stuck in another 2v1 situation here. Okay, nice nair. It's so pivotal that when you're fighting Little Mac that you make every attack count. Because if you do not, anything that's small or minuscule just gives him KO meter. So make sure every hit matters.
Yeah. Make sure everything has a purpose. Don't just be throwing out attacks and throw out attacks.
Right. And with that being said, HL Lincoln and Cody will actually go down a game. Kwaaaaz is in winter, so they're actually looking to reset this thing on him. Mm-hmm. All right. Okay, so we have this. Okay, and the real guns are coming out here.
Oh,
Cody has opted into going villager.
It's like no more of this Palutena thing.
Right.
She's fun, but there's money on the line.
Absolutely, man. First place money here, and these guys are fighting for it head on. Hopefully we can get some offstage gimping. I know Link is a pretty easy character to gimp, especially going up against somebody like Rob. His up special sadly sends him up and towards the ledge, and that's exactly where Rob likes to be at with that wonderful dare of his. But the same could be exactly said for Mac. Obviously, all it's going to take to get Mac is like a nair or two. If that, you know, if you catch him without a jump, he's as good as dead. If you can catch him on a grab release, you can kill him like that, dude.
Ooh, and the boomerang actually saving Kwaaaaz from getting hit with that dash attack there.
Yeah. Oh, and a wonderful tech right there, but sadly doesn't matter. But Quad A there to save his teammate, finds his way back on stage, but he does lose the KO punch in the process.
Oh,
but
no.
I think
did
it's worth
Quad
it.
Just kill? Okay. He had his jump.
Yeah. Okay, nice back throw right there. Very strong throw right there.
Oh, no, Lincoln. Shout out to Skilliger for saving him. Lincoln accidentally slipping off of the stage, and Quad A noticed, so he was going down there for the spike.
Definitely, man. Oh, that's jab lock. Oh, but no follow-up right there. And sadly, just charged the forest mask. I'm not quite sure what he was going for with that, but with the character that's as slippery as Little Mac and, like, Pikachu and Sonic, charging smash attacks is probably never, ever going to land on them. That's just not optimal. Oh, wow.
You got hoop dreams if you're doing that.
Basically.
Ooh, getting punished there.
Ooh, I'm liking how he's keeping Mac away with those nice bow and arrows, man.
Oh, yeah. Good keeping him in shield, then letting Villager take care of it.
Absolutely, man. Oh, wow, good force smash right there, but the gyro still saving him slightly, finds his way back on stage. I know that's not what the blue team wants to hear right now. They're doing a very good job of keeping Mac airborne, and every time they do that, then they just keep finding him back on stage. I know that that's not what they want to see here.
That was a really nice forward smash there by HL Lincoln. Mm-hmm. Seeing Kwaaaaz throwing out a forward smash that was not going to hit in his opponent. And at that point in time, he knew he was safe to throw one out himself.
Absolutely. Now, the blue team sitting in the slight lead here the first time between both matches. Three stocks right now to the green team's two. They're going to have to play this one very safely. I feel like if the green team probably focuses on Link a little bit, let Matt control the ground game, let maybe Rob control the airspace. I mean, that can be the death of any good Link. I mean, but the X factor is Villager. How long if that character is allowed to live? Because Cody does a very fantastic job staying in the 2v1. And clutching it out. Oh,
going too low, not making it back to the stage.
Yeah, very rough.
So that is going to leave Quad A by himself. Mm-hmm. Oh, man, then you got Villager. It's going to make it really hard for Quad A to come back to the stage. Mm-hmm. And then once you get onto the stage, you got to deal with Link and his sword.
Absolutely, man. Now, that fair is something that you have to maneuver around. Don't ever get hit by that by Link. That's like 25%.
Oh, no.
Okay.
Only
two parts of the up smash hit. Okay. And where is the pizza? We'll go ahead and take that one. Nothing like a good old-fashioned switch to Villager to switch the whole meta of the match. All right. Well, I don't expect to see a character switch from Kwaaaaz. Obviously, if we're this late in the bracket, we could possibly see Ryu, maybe, but for the most part, he's probably going to stay Mac. But we do see a Greninja. Okay, so now he wants a bit more mobility on his side. Okay, let's see what happens here.
A hammer, bro. All right, so we – ooh, no. So this is game number three.
Yeah.
Quad A and – Kwaaaz just lost, and they let Cody go to Dreamland.
Absolutely, man. Now, Cody knows a thing or two about living here on Dreamland, and he knows a thing or two about bringing nightmares here of all places. I mean, just, you know, Cody's just adaptability to the stage, just the tools that he has are just needed in order for him to clutch out any bad spot that he's in. Ooh, nice spot dodge right there on that forward smash. Okay, he's looking to land that KO puncher a little bit too close to Mac.
Makes it back to the stage there.
That's it.
Ooh, okay. KO punch. Wow. Villager's recovery is not going to help him out there.
Absolutely not. Now, he had the right idea there. He almost had the ledge trump. He almost had the good get-up punish, but sadly, man, down tilt, it confirms into KO punch. Pretty good there. Oh, wow. Very unfortunate.
He was trying to get over those balloons.
That he was.
So we're on Dreamland, 43%, at Villager, and okay, Greninja losing his first stock here. But earlier I touched on how I didn't like this stage pick because Villager is probably the hardest character to kill in the game, all right?
No, he's definitely the hardest character to kill.
He's the hardest character to kill. Dreamland's side blast zones are going to be so immense. Mm-hmm. It's just ridiculous. He's not going to die off the side. He's going to be able to come back. And then also we have Villager who has the sapling that's just going to hide in those flowers there if he ever decides to use the tree.
Yeah.
But that's actually one thing I haven't seen him use at all in this set.
Absolutely not, man, which is really strange because, you know, the tree is something that I believe is super optimal, you know, for doubles gameplay. Obviously, it cushions the blow. It allows you to hide for a little bit. And then on top of that, you have your axe. I mean, you can really do a lot with that tree. But, you know, we'll just have to see what happens here. Just in terms of killing Villager, unfortunately, you're not going to be able to stage spike that guy until, like, 150-60%, especially if he's in the right hands. So, oh, wow. No stage snap right there. And just, unfortunately, you just ate a bowling ball, dude.
Ooh, okay. So, Cody fiddling around under the stage there. Ooh. Kwaaaaz running in, punishing with the up smash, yep. Taking an early stock.
Now, Kwaaaaaz has been doing a very good job at handling Cody these last few sets. I'm not quite sure what it is, but, hey, man, a dead Cody is a good Cody, especially if you're fighting against him. Oh, that's it. Wow.
Oh, Quad A with the save and then makes it back to the stage. Can we get this man a cape?
Oh, ooh, wow.
Lincoln lives.
Yeah, man.
Lincoln would have died.
Dude, I know he would have been pretty hot about that. Now, I know the ceiling here is low, but, you know, Link is just a very heavy guy just in general. So he has a lot of equipment that he's holding on to him. So. I just want to give a quick shout out to Wesley, man, and how good he is as a teammate.
Yeah.
He understands that he is not the aggressor in this situation, that he does play a very good beta role, and he does a very good job at knowing where his opponent is weak, and he knows where to help out when needed.
I felt like in that situation there, it's really funny that you were just talking about how great of a teammate he was when he actually just killed his teammate.
Yeah.
As you were saying that.
Rest in peace.
Sadly hitting him with a nair, knocking him off stage, and we have HL Lincoln hitting with the fair and Villager, you know, just you're chilling. Like, yeah, match. Match
yeah.
One.
All right, so where is the pizza looking to obviously try to bring this one back here? Now, they have a few matches on their side that they have to use to reset. Meanwhile, Kwaaaaz is sitting very comfortable in winners today. So we'll see what happens, man. Like I mentioned, Kwaaaaaz is having one of those days that he's doing
just
very, very
doing phenomenal.
Yeah, he's doing phenomenal. And he's doing so phenomenal that the Ryu has actually come out of retirement. I know he played Darkshad at Smash and Splash, too. And Darkshad kind of gave him the hands, but the hands inspired him. Dude, it was pretty bad. Like, you know those vines you see on Twitter?
Yeah.
Where it's like, you know, footstool narrow you across the stage
those
and spikes
you're
you.
Like, that never happens.
Oh, that happened.
Oh!
That happened. And I looked over just at the tail end of it right before the spike, and I looked at Kwaaaaz, and Kwaaaaz looked at me. Then I looked at Kwaaaaz back, and he looked at me again. And then I looked at him, and he looked at me. I just walk away, bro, because it was bad.
Oh, no. Kwaaaz, look at the screen.
It was bad, man. Kwaaaaz made one of those faces, and that was it. But he has the face of victory here today as he's sitting comfortably in winter. So we'll see what happens.
So we have Quad A whipping out his new character, Diddy. Which I don't know. Have you seen this Diddy before?
I have not. I know he played it a few matches earlier in bracket, but for the most part, that Diddy is pretty new to me. So I'm one of those firm believers too that Diddy has the best neutral in the game, and Ryu is the best character in the game. So with these two together on teams, I don't see why they can't sit comfortably. Yeah. Right now and try to edge out on Wednesday and don't get this bracket reset on them, because when you get that bracket reset on you, man, that's just rough on the mental, dude. That's like, dude, I just messed this comfortable lead up. You know, they're on fire now. They have what it takes basically to beat me.
So Kwaaaz is already on his last stock. Mm-hmm. He was on his last stock. Well, they both had three stocks still. Yeah. I do not see this turning in their favor. Mm-hmm. Really questioning what they can do to try and turn this around.
Yeah, I like Ryu a lot in singles, but just in doubles, I think it's a little different, man. He pretty much starts a lot of the combo throws, and he gets a lot of good follow-ups.
Yeah.
But for the most part, in terms of team synergy, he's a little lackluster. Now, he can do things like that, like obviously up tilt into up special, confirmed up special too, the true one. But, I mean, that's pretty much if we're doing the two 1v1 situations. But if we can get some team synergy a little bit better from these – we might have ourselves a show here, but we'll see what happens.
And that was a really nice down tilt that HL Lincoln did there a couple moments ago. The person that he was supposed to be fighting was off stage, so he came in, lend a helping hand to help Villager start up a combo.
Yeah, for sure, dude. Now, Villager's not really the combo starter. He's kind of the one that keeps it going, man, with a lot of those nairs, like what we've seen in, like, Genesis 3 with Komo, Akiri, and Renai team, and that's just like, you know, throw, nair, finishing touch. So Villager is very good at keeping those going. Now, he does have Diddy Kong's banana, which is one of Quad A's optimal tools in terms of getting kills and racking up damage. Not to say that he can't do it without it.
Yeah.
That's the best neutral in the game, but he definitely needs that banana. And as long as Cody's alive, he's keeping that thing.
And the banana is what makes his neutral so wonderful. Ooh,
yeah.
Forward smash. is going to live. And then we have Lincoln throwing out yet another forward or down smash at a very questionable time. What happened to Diddy Kong?
I'm not quite sure, but unfortunately he is out of the picture here.
I think he just lost where he was.
Yeah, and I definitely agree, dude. Lincoln has definitely been throwing a lot of random smash attacks just at just bad moments. It's doubles, you know. Use that shield button. It's going to be a lot of shielding. There's not going to be a lot of smash attacks unless you know that you can land it. But with that being said, where is Jacob? Resets that young bracket.
I thought you were asking where Jacob was. No. Like, Jacob, man, I don't know. He's probably at home right now.
Nah, I know where he's at.
Playing some Overwatch or something.
Right.
Shout out to the Overwatch tournament that's going on here today. They're pretty stacked. They got the stream going on the screen over there. It's really nice. Got the PC boys coming.
Yeah.
So, we have a reset. Reset is never good for the team that gets reset on. You just start off the first match on tilt. Mm-hmm. Like, oh my gosh, I made it all this way, and I let them win a set. And for the team that did the reset, you have to wonder about the fatigue.
Yeah. They're fighting from losers right now. They're fighting with their back against the wall. I mean, they really have the weight of the world on their shoulders here, because at this point, you don't want to make it all this way, you know, obviously just to fall short of victory. So you definitely want to make sure that you make these matches count here. While the team and winners, I mean, they just lost their comfortability. Now the world's shaking up a little bit. They're trying to hold on to this victory as much as possible. But this blue team, very unfortunate. And Ryu going back to the abyss. Cody sending a message telling him, bro, you should have stayed in Street Fighter, bro. Don't come back to Smash in the next one.
Telling Kwaaaz to put that down, boy.
Put that down, bro. It ain't what you think.
So, as we talked about fatigue just a moment ago, it really makes me wonder how Skilliger and HL Lincoln are going to perform in singles with having to play all these matches in doubles, because they started off in losers round one.
Mm-hmm. I mean, there's like a point in time where you're thinking, okay, I'm pretty warmed up, you know. Yeah. I've played a few matches in doubles. I got my movement down. My hands are warmed up. But then there's also I played too many matches today. And I need a break. But you know what, though? That's why they're on the PR.
Oh, no, shield break.
Oh, rest in peace, Villager. Wow. Early deaths like that are something that we're not normally used to seeing here by Skilliger, which is really strange, man. You know, he's pretty good at tanking this thing out. He does pretty well against Mac and staying alive. But here recently, it could be the solid break that
–
yeah, that it could be the break that he took. I'm not quite sure what it is. Or maybe it's the fact that he's not used to teaming with Link.
Now, the really crazy thing is he had 100 damage, and you said taking a stock early, and then you think about it, he's like, man, yeah, he is Villager. Yep. Villager was probably going to live for a probably another 50%.
Definitely.
Against normal characters. Rob with his really giant hitboxes, sometimes he'd be able to take that, and then Ryu, I mean, when can't Ryu take your stock, right?
Yeah. Like, he doesn't need much to take your stock anymore, especially since his meta has been explored a bit more since his release last summer. People are starting to figure out how to use him optimally. They're figuring out how to just go hard with him, and it's ugly now, man. That's why I feel like Ryu's the best character in the game. Wow, but doesn't quite get that Shoryuken death like he was looking for, and unfortunately Kwade was looking to save him there.
Too strong of an attack. I don't know if Rob really has an attack that can his fair maybe. Mm-hmm. But even at that percent that Ryu was at, it was gonna put him in a really bad position.
Now, if I'm Link and I'm fighting Ryu, the best thing that you can do versus him is grab him.
Yeah.
Don't even try to fight him straight up. He's going to beat you down up close. But if you can figure out how to get your grab game crisp, down throw, up tilt, those are good tools right there to rack up early damage. Wow. Link having a bit of an issue landing. Rack up early damage there on Ryu, man. He's pretty big. He's pretty easy to combo. Use the tools that you have wisely.
Yeah. Ooh, and Kwaaaz, that was beautiful. He was waiting for him. Ran up to HL Lincoln. HL Lincoln just had his shield up like, oh my gosh, it's Ryu. I'm pretty sure he was just intimidated by the fact that Ryu was next to him, and he knew that he was in kill percent. Mm-hmm. He was just holding his shield, until it was too small that he knew that Ryu was going to break his shield if he didn't do anything.
Absolutely.
Drop shield, and Kwaaaz punished.
Absolutely, man. Punished optimally, too. I mean, that's just what you have to do, dog. Like, Ryu does a very, very good job at punishing. I mean, I think that's pretty much the nature of the character and just the nature of competitive Street Fighter. Like, your job is to punish when needed, and he does a very good job at that.
Oh my gosh, that would have been a beautiful pass, leading the receiver into the end zone.
Right. Okay, and Cody doing what Cody does best, man, playing very strong with his back against the wall. I mean, Villager is probably the best character to use in a two.
See how far away he was?
Oh, my God.
You see how far away he was? Oh, gosh. But shout out to Attacks with Super Armor on frame one.
Dude, I will say that I've seen Cody come through with a lot of victories with his back against the wall. Mm-hmm. He's triumphed through a lot. But I agree that he has a mental stigma against the DLC characters, which is pretty strange because, yeah, some of the DLC characters are jank, but Villager was like the first jank normal character in this game too. So, like, I just remember fighting against Villager like day one when that character, when the game came out, excuse me, I'm just like, dude,
why don't you die?
Please die. What is happening?
Like, dude? Did you just throw a forward smash at me?
We're on it. Die, bro. Die.
So, here at Duck Hunt, why do you think they went to Duck Hunt?
Possibly because maybe Lincoln needs more room to work here. I'm not quite sure, man. I know, like, up close and personal, he loses a lot of the projectiles that he wants to use because, obviously, there's the risk of running into your teammate and hitting them with – oh, my God. Lincoln with another smash attack and a force he takes out his teammate. You know, you just run the risk of hitting your teammate with your projectiles. But here, though, you have a lot of room to work. But on the flip side, this forces a 2-1v1 situation. I'm not quite sure if Lincoln is up to date on the Ryu matchup. And I know Kwaaaaz is looking to pick apart the opponent's team synergy
No. And then the way that Lincoln plays his Link, he's very smash attack happy.
Yeah, that he is.
That is not good against Ryu because your smash attacks are not going to break his focus attack.
Yeah. Well, that forward smash might because you need two hits to but I know a lot of times most people who use Link don't throw the second one just in fear of being punished because there's just a lot of ending lag on a lot of his smash attacks, but we'll just see what happens.
Sadly a miscommunication there and now they have to deal with a full rage Link.
I mean, 168% too. This is ugly. My God, that should do it. Wow, good save there for Palutena. Yes, I'm actually interested to see how well Palutena does against Ryu, man, especially off stage with those back airs. Oh, no, Ryu, find a way to land, please.
And somehow he makes it out of that situation. I believe the dog may have played a part in it.
Mm-hmm. That dang meddling dog.
And they found their groove again. What do you think happened?
From the blue team's perspective or the green team's perspective?
For the green team.
You know what? Like I mentioned earlier, I just think it's the fact that this stage is so big and you can really pick apart the blue team together. Like, their team synergy has definitely progressed since round one here into grand finals in the bracket reset. But I still think separately, though, the green team might have the slight edge. Yes, Cody is a very strong guy. He can handle any 2v1 situation. But when you have to fight in a 1v1 while worrying about your teammate across the screen, getting just true Shoryu by Ryu, I mean, it's rough on the mental. Wow.
Ooh, the dare.
But so is the dare, though. The dare is definitely rough on anybody's skull.
The dare taking the stock, which is actually really surprising to me. I know in the other Smash games, I love to use Link's dare with the passion because I knew it was going to kill people. And I feel like in this one, they didn't make it to where it killed like it used to. Mm-hmm. But you do get some really cool things out of it. Like I've seen you many times use the dare on somebody twice and then throw out an up air, and I'm just like, that's just a beautiful kill setup.
Absolutely. Now, that has actually always been a thing, but that Shoryu hasn't always been a thing until now in Smash 4. But the dare, I definitely agree with you, man, because we played a lot of Brawl, you know, coming up, and that dare was like a very useful killing tool. If I caught you up there in that blast zone, I was throwing that out, you were as good as dead. And now it still works pretty good, but it's more used for spiking. It does a lot of knockback, but it doesn't give me the knockback that I once knew. Wow. Okay, and Where Is Pizza will go up another game as well, too. Palutena might be the queen hero that we need.
So
heroine, I guess.
When the tournament's over today and Skilliger goes home and he sees Dr. Pizza probably sitting on his couch with his shoes off, just his feet lounging, what do you think he's going to say to him?
I don't know. He's probably going to do his laugh, his huh-huh, and then just, like, walk off or something. I don't know.
He'd probably say something that can't say on stream here.
Oh, probably,
the younger viewers.
Right, the potty mouth. With the all 8 viewers in our chat. Okay, and this is not where we wanted to go. Let's go ahead and just kill ourselves real quick.
Oh, no. RIP, everybody.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure they don't want to take Palutena here so she can get those early up air kills, but
they definitely don't want to mess around with the platforms there. Right now, we are going into game number 3 of Grand Finals, the reset. Mm-hmm. And it looks like they did want to go to Dreamland. I'm not too sure what the issue was. Mm-hmm. Character change. So right now we have Kwaaaaz going Marth.
Okay.
Characters you should be very familiar with because, I mean, you know, he's a melee guy.
Yes, sir. And Marth got some pretty decent buffs here in the last few weeks and months. Obviously, when the game came out, a lot of people were like, okay, what's happening to Marth here? He was really good in melee. He was really good in Brawl and PM. But Smash 4, he's a little lackluster, man. That sword seems significantly stronger. It's harder to get tippers now. But with the patch that Corrin and Bayonetta came out in 1.14, like I've always told people, like there was that little trailer where we got to watch actually some of that gameplay on the Umbra Falling Clock Tower. It was Marth, Pit, Corrin, and Bayonetta. But what I was most excited about is the fact that Marth got some very strong buffs. Jab into fair now. Fair into back air is a thing. I mean, he just has so many optimal tools now in his arsenal, more than what he had recently.
And it really surprised me. Well, no, I wouldn't say that it surprised me. It really showed me like how many Smash buffs there are out there that are the data miners looking for things.
Yeah.
You know, if I would have saw that, well, I'm paying attention to the match. I'm not paying attention to, oh, this attack does 3% more now.
Yeah. No, I definitely really agree, man. For me, you know, Marth was like one of my secondaries in Brawl, and I actually had to retire him for a whole year in Smash 4. So, I mean, I'm with it. I'm with it now, dude. I'm definitely with Team Marth here. And on top of that, that up smash kind of scoops you from the left and right now a bit more than what it used to. So him and Lucina sitting pretty right.
Hitting him with the true. So right now, red team sitting with a slight advantage. Really wondering if Quad A can stay on the ground. He's had a lot of trouble this match, staying on the ground, falling into HL Lincoln's up smashes.
No, I definitely agree, man. And the problem with that is Marth, I believe, he spends so much time in the air. A lot of his good approach tools come from his aerials. Short hop fair, short hop near. So it's kind of hard to stay out of the air a lot of times. And when you got Link just running up on you, throwing up smashes just left and right, it's so rough to deal with. But I do appreciate the switch to Marth because what I'm planning on seeing here is him throw Link off. And the minute that he uses his up B, obviously he'll throw out his counter, killing Link.
So Quad A almost at full – just forget what I was going to say.
Yeah, right.
Almost at full rage, but with the true Shuri taking HL Lincoln out, who was playing so well against him. Just a couple moments ago, we actually had Ryu on the ledge there doing a focus attack, and Lincoln jumped up and did Link's fair, which we know is a two-hit move.
Absolutely.
There was nothing that he was going to be able to do. That second move was going to be able to hit him out of it. All he had to do was, you know, try and cancel it and shield. Wasn't able to do it and died from the fair.
Absolutely, man. Unfortunately, sometimes you just have to play your options right. And just in that situation there, that was one where, I mean, you were stuck in a rock and in between a rock and a hard spot. So, I mean, there wasn't really much you could do there. But
great punish.
Yeah, we got Palutena right now stuck in another rough 2v1 situation. Now, I've seen a second ago Kwaaaaz was trying to get that chain of soft up tilts going. Palutena is a big body, a semi-big hurt box, you know. Could definitely get her to the side of the stage and spike her, but.
Oh, yeah. I see a true ending it. Ooh, a true forward smash.
Okay.
Okay. So we have green team showing that the fight has not died in them. Shout out to Kwaaaaz for making it to grand finals, getting the bracket reset on them. And then actually coming back and making this set count 2-1.
Yeah, man, doing a very good job of holding down this lead here. I know that, like you said before, getting the bracket reset on you could be rough on the mental, but you know what? You got to hold it down, man, not only just for the sake of doubles, but also for the sake of your singles run later on after this. So I know all these guys got some matches to play probably, so I know they're going to be rushing this.
Holding up all the brackets in the world.
Right.
I know I'm holding one up.
Oh, no. All right, but we're here right now in town and city, man, so we could see some very early kills just clear off the top if they're not safe. Now, the stage is as big as Final Destination, and it has platforms for a little bit, so let's see if Palutena can get some of those up air combos going. That's saying that the opponent doesn't tech.
Yeah. You know one thing that I really noticed about hypertension tournaments?
What's that?
Man, people die from from upsetting things like that. But there are a lot of bracket resets and doubles.
Yes.
Would you not agree?
I definitely agree, and I think that problem is because 9 times out of 10, people aren't normally teaming with their respective teammate. They're always kind of just fishing around, hey, man, you want a team? Yeah. Nah, man, I don't want to team with you. I don't really want to do this. I don't really want to do that. And, you know, we get in the grand finals, and just the chemistry switches so much back and forth between both sides that it's moving, man. It's really crazy sometimes.
In this match, I really see H.O. Lincoln dying really early again. Ooh, nice job blocking that and not trying to go for an attack afterwards because he knew that he was going to do the little bounce off the shield.
Mm-hmm. Now, Lincoln fishing for a lot of smash attacks, yep. And here is the respective stage to do it. He has a bit more room to work with as opposed to somewhere like Smashville, where you're very confined to a short space. You have to worry about your teammate. Here, it's okay to throw forward smash every now and then. Don't get too Lincoln. And just
that was definitely worth it, though.
I believe so, yes. And ate the uppercut of a century, unfortunately. And Marth plummets his demise, using his up special a little bit too far away from the stage.
Oh, no. And Lincoln making it back to the stage there.
Yeah.
I think he was going to make it back even if Kwaaaaz didn't hop down there, I'm pretty sure he still would have made it back either way. So it's nice to hop off and get the extra damage.
Oh, yeah, absolutely, dude.
Ooh, nice counter.
Oh, my God. And the tipper back air right there. And Marth feeling like a brand new man. Feeling like, you know, Melee Marth up in here, dude. Doing a very good job of keeping the Goddess of Light and the Hero of Time at bay.
Man, we have a lot of offstage shenanigans going on there. And Lincoln just runs over and grabs very
No, Brett, no.
No, forward smashes are things.
Oh, my goodness. He got the tipper forward smash from Mark, accompanied by the Feet of Justice by Ryu. Not a good spot to be in ever, man. And unfortunately, met the blast
stabs
zones.
Him in the heart there. Going for the oh no, Quad, what are you doing?
Oh no.
He was like, you know what, I'm gonna give you some help here, Skilliger.
Yeah, I didn't mean to do your boy like that. I'm gonna go ahead and just jump off one time.
But right now, I mean, I just don't see Skilliger being able to pull this.
Ooh. Oh,
well, that was what I was gonna say, I was gonna be right. See him able to pull that out with Ryu just being able to do another Shiryuken whenever he wanted to. I'm just like, yeah, that's it's going to end it. Yeah. So this was really exciting to see, you know, not the star doubles team come through and win. Mm-hmm. Shout out to Hey.